Good evening. Welcome. It would be wonderful if we could have everybody find a place to sit. We are very excited to have so many parents and friends and family. I guess parents are family too. All right, before we get going, I have an announcement. If I can have your attention, class, please. What? Thank you. Can we turn down the gain a little bit? Thank you. Before we get started, I wanted to share with you, when we are done tonight, and I hope I have your attention, this feels like school all over again. When we are done tonight, we're going to ask that we have you guys exit the building. Music students and their relatives are invited to come to the cafeteria. We're going to have a reception to have an opportunity to share with one another before we say goodbye for the school year. Everyone else, you can either go to the dormitory or go to rec. But the supervision team has been working really hard, and I know they're tired. I've done it, so I know what's all about. So we want to kindly ask that when the program is done, that we can get moving and let them close the building. It's very important for us to do that. Now, as we prepare for the program tonight, I really hope that all of you have a music program. I mentioned that yesterday, and I want to make sure that everybody does. If you don't, raise your hand. See, can we have some people in the back, Michael or Ethan, and just see the people that don't have programs and make sure that they can get a music program. I say this because I want you to know what we're doing, at least with the Wind Symphony portion. It will tell you a little bit about the pieces that we're going to be performing tonight. I think that gives you a little bit of context, and it'll make it so it makes more sense. And with that being said, I hope everyone can find a place to sit. Even the people in the back, please feel free to come forward and find a place to sit. Thank you, programs are coming. At this time, I would like to ask that we bow our heads and we have a word of prayer. Dear Lord, dear Father, we are thankful that we can be here tonight, and we don't want to take for granted the great gift of life and the opportunity that you've given us to not only be here, but be with one another. I pray that as we play music, that the focus will not be on us, on the human instrument, but that it may be on you, because you're the one who enables us to be able to do what we do, and we want to do it not for us, but for you. And yes, we do enjoy it. We get great satisfaction and joy to be able to do this. But we don't want to forget that we're only able to do it because of you, and we do it for you. We love you, Lord, and we ask for your blessing. And may this be a blessing for everyone here. For we pray and ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. This time I would like to have the honor to invite Samantha Ramashko. She's a senior graduating this year, and she's been a wonderful member of our group and a wonderful contributor to this department, and it's a true honor to have her conduct one of our pieces today. And if you want to know more about her, you can read in the program, in the back of the program. Thank you, Sammy. It is crazy to see how all the students grow. Some of them we have for 4 years, some of them not quite four, some of them more than four. And they become your children, and you hate to see them go, but you know it's for good. At this time, before I continue and we go with our next piece called Entrada, I wanted to take a brief moment to thank some people. And this specifically refers to people who have contributed to this department of music in many ways. And right now I'm thinking of some people that have contributed to make it possible recently in the last couple years financially. And that is to make it possible for our department to have those gorgeous timpani that we have. And we are so ever thankful for those people who've given so much to make it happen and to enable us to do what we do. We're so thankful for you. And we will ever be thankful. But I also want to take an opportunity to thank someone else that I hope is here. This is a wonderful lady that was gracious and wonderful and kind enough to donate that marimba that is sitting right there. We didn't have one, and this just came just like an answer to prayer. And her name is Evelyn Lutz, and I hope she's here. Are you here, Evelyn? Would you mind standing, please? We want to say thank you to you so much. It means the world to us. You know, it makes a big difference to have the generosity of people that help us to give an opportunity for the students to use their talents. And at this time, Evelyn, I asked Sammy, the one that just conducted, she's our section leader in the percussion section, and she's gonna play the marimba. She's gonna play your marimba, and she's gonna play an excerpt. It's not gonna be very long, but she wants to play a little for you.
Thank you. Good evening, friends. Good evening, friends. It's so good to see you all here. Thank you for coming. I'll just share with you a couple things while we transition. I want to start by saying that 2 weeks ago, we had the privilege of being in Dalton, Georgia, and sharing music there. And then we worked our way up to the Nashville area, shared there last Saturday, 2 weeks ago, Saturday night. But it's really exciting to be here tonight, sharing with all of you, parents, family, friends, and neighbors. So thank you for coming. I also want to say that we had the privilege this year, many of us, of going to Israel to film a production. And you may have seen some of the videos on the screen playing before the concert. We have a lot of those videos from Israel also. And if you want to know more about them, look at the website on the back of your programs and keep in touch with us. We would love to have you follow along. We'll show you more pictures in the middle a little bit later on. And we will also be collecting a free will offering. If you want to support the work of ministry that the Great Lakes Adventist Academy Department of Music is doing, we want you to think ahead to that. So thank you again for coming. May God bless you as we continue to share the good news of Jesus in music.
Speaketh, now he bids. Lift him up in all his glory. 'Tis the Son of God on high.
Lift him up, his love shall draw them. The careless shall draw high. Let them hear again the story of the cross, the death of shame, and from tongue to tongue repeated, mighty throngs will bless his name.
Oh, then lift him up in singing, lift the Savior up in prayer. Yes, the young shall bow before him, the old their voices raise. All the deaf shall hear Hosanna, and the dumb shall shout his praise. Lift him up, the risen Savior. I am made the reigning crown. Lift him up, 'tis he that speaketh. Now he bids you flee from bound. Lift him up, the risen Savior. I am made the waiting crown. Lift him up, 'tis he that speaketh. Now he bids you flee from wrong.
Sharing your there's something special about sharing our last performance here on such a beautiful Sabbath. There was also something special about that night Nicodemus came to Jesus, and Jesus explained how we are to be reborn again, and how just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up. Jesus was the one lifted up on the cross. He took our sins, our mistakes, put them on the cross, nailed them there, and was lifted up with them. He died the second death, so we don't have to. What a gift that is. What a treasure. Who are we to deny Jesus of his noble sacrifice? The selfless one, the sinless one. So I just invite all of you tonight to accept his gift without all of us, the gift of Jesus dying on the cross.
Thank you.
charm me most. I sacrifice them to His love. See from His head, His hands, His feet, sorrow and love foaming all down. Tears of
you know, one of my favorite gospel stories is of how Jesus healed the leper. Because the leper was thought to be one of the most terrible of sinners. But Jesus was willing to touch the leper and to heal him. Today, Jesus is willing to touch each and every one of us and heal us of our disease of sin. Won't you accept him?
He touched me.
We'd like to just show you a few pictures from our trip to Israel. God blessed in so many amazing ways. And I had the privilege of going there in July with our film team to get the permits rolling and to choose the places, to go back early with the crew and then to meet up with the symphony and singers when they came. And I'll just say that our God is a God who can open any door. We saw doors close only so that God could open better doors, bigger doors, better opportunities. I'll just tell you one. We had met with the city police in Old Jerusalem back in July and said, you know, we can't afford to go inside Herod's palace where Jesus was tried, but we'd like to film on the streets right outside because it's very impressive. And they said, not a problem. Come back in March and we'll just give you a license. Well, what do you know? We came back in March and they said, oh no, you can't do that. There's going to be a bicycle this and a marathon that, and it's dangerous out there. You need to go inside. Well, praise the Lord is right. I heard somebody say, praise the Lord. My first thought was, that's impossible. Number one, we're here and we got to film in 2 days. Number two, it'll cost too much. But with a prayer and with our guide, inside we went and the Lord worked it out. And I will tell you, you will want to see our Story of Jesus production with footage from a boat on the Sea of Galilee, riding camels toward Bethlehem, in Old Jerusalem, in Capernaum, on the Mount of Olives, the Mount of Blessing. It was such an exciting opportunity to be in all of those places. So again, I'd encourage you to keep an eye on the website, our GLA website, and we'll be letting you know when those productions will be released. But at this time, I just want to encourage you to join us now in giving, if you're able and if you're willing, and the young people will wait on you as we share more music and as the pictures continue to roll.
Thank you. There's a line that is drawn through the ages. On that line stands the old rugged cross. On that cross, a battle is raging for the gain of man's soul or his loss. On one side march the forces of evil, all the demons and devils of hell.
On the other, the angels of glory, and they beat on Golgotha.
The earth shakes with the force of the conflict, and the sun, it refuses to shine. For there hangs God's Son in the balance, and then through the darkness he cries.
The battle is over.
name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God hath done. Are you ever burdened with the load of care? Does the cross seem heavy? You are called to bear. Count your many blessings, every doubt will fly.
And you will be singing as the days go by. Do, 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 do. Someone in the valley, whether great or small, do not be discouraged, God is over all. Count your many blessings, angels will attend. They'll comfort you to your journey's end.
Count your blessings one by one. Count your blessings, see what God hath done. Count your many blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God hath done. Count your many blessings, see what God hath done.
The gates. Thank you. Lift him up, the risen Savior. Think of the story of the serpents in the wilderness. Young and old were dying from these poisonous snake bites, and all the children of Israel had to do was look at a bronze serpent lifted up on a pole, and they would live. Growing up, I always wondered, why didn't everyone just look? It seems like the logical thing to do, right? But maybe you and I do the same thing today. Today, the choice is still ours. Will we look and live? Will we look to Jesus today and every day? Will we walk and talk with him today and for the rest of our lives? If we do, we have nothing but sin and selfishness and death to lose and all heaven to gain. Jesus is coming so soon. We say it all the time, but do we live it in our everyday lives? Now is the moment to decide. Will we look to Jesus today? Will we walk and talk with him today and every day? The choice is ours.
Thank you.
The promise is sure. When Jesus is lifted up, there's power. Power enough to take you and me through. Because truth will march on. The only question is whether or not we march with it. And by God's grace, we can march with it. Let's stand together and thank God for what he's done tonight and what he's done through this year. We thank you for coming. Let's ask God's blessing as we go our way. Heavenly Father, your truth is marching on. We praise you for what you did when you died on Calvary. You've paid the price, and you've promised that if you are lifted up, you will draw all men to you. May we lift you in our lives this week and through the next school year. Thank you for the way you've blessed our efforts in the Department of Music here at Great Lakes Adventist Academy this year. And we give you all the praise and the glory. And we thank you for the opportunity of being servants in your vineyard. Lord, bless each person tonight. Guide us through the week ahead. May we lift you up in the way we live. We pray. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Amen. Thank you all for coming. Have a wonderful evening. Right now. I can do it.
Thank you. Hello. Hello. Hello.
There's going to be another year.
Michael. Michael. We want to remind everyone that music students and their families are invited to come to the cafeteria. Others are welcome to go to a